Hello all you Clash Commanders out there, and welcome to another episode of Clash on Clashington. It has come to both my team and I's attention that, despite a few months of playtesting and balancing the rules of Clash, a change must still be made, along with a little clarification of other rules. This change involves the slapping out mechanic. Initially, slapping out involved playing a minion over another conscious minion, but there were requirements that needed to be met. 1. The minion being played, or the minion that was slapping out the conscious minion, would need a base buffiness equal to or higher than the conscious minion. An action must be spent, for it is still the act of playing a new minion, and the minion being played still needed to meet the level requirements of the slot it was being placed in. Now, with current changes, the first requirement is no longer necessary. Any minion can slap out another, regardless of their buffiness. Why have we made this change? Well, 1. It allows more versatile gameplay, especially with keeping minions in your hand playable, and 2, it simplifies the game. Simple as that. That is all we need to discuss with the change in rules, but we're not done just yet. A little explanation for other aspects of Clash on Clashington will answer some questions you guys may have, such as, what is considered an empty slot, and what can I do with my cards in a finished Clashington? Well, for the empty slot question, a slot is considered empty if it contains no conscious minions for minion slots, or active cards for non-minion slots. This means that you can have a pile of unconscious minions in a single minion slot, but is still considered empty. As long as there are no conscious minions in it, it is empty. Same goes for circumstance and event slots with active cards. Because of this, your event slot will usually be considered empty, for event cards are played, then become inactive immediately afterwards. While the circumstance slot is the opposite, for circumstance cards remain active until played over by another circumstance or some other effect. And for the cards that you have played in a finished Clashington, they are inaccessible unless a special effect notes otherwise, where it allows you to search a completed Clashington. Now remember, cards in a completed Clashington are not to be thought of as part of the torn up pile, for that is a separate section of the board. If you guys are still unclear about some of the rules for Clash, an instructions guide is uploaded on the Dropbox page and can be accessed through a link in the description below. The instructions guide will always be updated, so it is your most reliable piece of information to play the most recent version of Clash. So on that note, I hope things have become a little clearer for you Clash commanders out there, and from this I hope you guys enjoy more fun games of Clash. Keep on clashing.